It's 2024. You want to build a mobile app and can't afford to hire me. So the next best thing, a no-code mobile app builder. But there's so many. Which ones are good? Which ones are bad? Which ones are meh? This video answers all that because we are ranking all of them. And by all, I mean 50, which is still a lot. Welcome to the 2024 no-code mobile app builder tier list. I'll review and rank 15 no-code mobile app builders. To any first-time viewers, this is my second app builder tier list. The first was for no-code web app builders, where I ranked 19 of them. From industry giants all the way to ones I've never heard of before. I already explained why and how I made an app builder tier list in that video, so I don't want to repeat myself too much, but here's the TLDR. First, why a tier list video? I feel YouTubers recommend the same app builders again and again. Always the same top three. We're telling people use ABC, but look at the comments and people are asking about DEF. People are also asking how this app builder compares to that app builder. Many of these questions go unanswered. A tier list with a scoring system lets me quickly but accurately and reliably assess a large number of app builders. It lets you have a better understanding of all these options and you can objectively compare all of them. And by all, I mean 15, which is still a lot. Second, how does a no-code app builder tier list work? I'll be using 7 metrics to evaluate every no-code mobile app builder. Customization options, I can build powerful apps with built-in components alone. Extend with custom code, I can further customize with my own code. Templates, I just need minimal edits to be launch ready. Code export, I can download the source code anytime. Success stories, lots of finished products on their showcase page, mobile and web. I can build both a mobile and web app if I want. Documentation, I can refer to official guides if stuck on a range of topics. In real life, certain metrics matter differently depending on your needs. But I want a general tier list that all of you can use, so I've given each metric equal weightage. If an app builder doesn't satisfy the description of a metric, it gets a 0. If it does the minimum to satisfy a description, it gets a 1. If it goes beyond this minimum, it gets a 2. For example, a mobile app builder that doesn't let you build web apps gets a 0 for the web and mobile metric. If in addition to mobile apps, it lets you build very basic web apps, gets a 1. If it also lets you build full-featured web applications with highly responsive design, it gets a 2. Same goes for every metric. Then I tally the scores and assign the app builder to one of 4 tiers. If an app builder gets a perfect score, they go to God tier. 10 to 13 and they go into A tier, great choices. 5 to 9 and it's B tier, not terrible but could do better. Anything below 5 goes into crap tier. After looking around, I found 15 no-code mobile app builders. Sat down with my team, went through them, scored them, ranked them all, and now I want to share the results with you. Let's start with the first one, Adalo. Customization option, 1. Extend with custom code, 1. Templates, 2. Code export, 0. Success stories, 2. Web and mobile, 2. Documentation, 2. Total score, 10. Strong start to our tier list with Adalo going into A tier. Next, Glide. Customization option, 1. Extend with custom code, 0. Templates, 2. Code export, 0. Success stories, 2. Web and mobile, 1. Documentation, 2. Total score of 8. Our second entry goes into B tier. What a roller coaster of emotions this tier list has been. Next, Fliplet. Customization options, 1. Extend with custom code, 2. Templates, 2. Code export, 0. Success story, 2. Web and mobile, 2. Documentation, 2. Total score, 11. I actually never heard of Fliplet before doing research for this tier list. It looks really good. A tier. Next, Bravo Studio. Customization options, 2. Extend with custom code, 0. Templates, 1. Code export, 0. Success stories, 2. Web and mobile, 0. Documentation, 2. Total score of 7. Putting Bravo Studio in B tier. Next, Gapsy. Customization options, 1. Extend with custom code, 0. Templates, 1. Code export, 0. Success stories, 1. Web and mobile, 2. Documentation, 1. Total score of 6. Only because they offer web and mobile, they go into B tier. Barely. Next, Batty Blocks. Customization options, 1. Extend with custom code, 2. Templates, 1. Code export, 0. Success stories, 2. Web and mobile, 2. Documentation, 2. Total score of 10. Another one for A tier. Next, Good Barber. customization options, 1. Extend with custom code, 1. Templates, 1. Code export, 0. Success stories, 1. Web and mobile, 2. Documentation, 1. Total score, 7. B tier. Next, Flutterflow. Customization options, 2. Extend with custom code, 2. Templates, 2. Code export, 2. Success stories, 2. Web and mobile, 2. Documentation, 2. Unsurprisingly, Flutterflow smashes it with a total score of 14. I can't believe I'm saying this, but Flutterflow is God tier. Next, Thunkable. Customization options, 1. Extend with custom code, 0. Templates, 2. Code export, 0. Success stories, 1. Web and mobile, 2. Documentation, 2. I should add that the templates aren't official Thunkable templates, but they are part of the official Thunkable initiative to get users to share resources. Total score, 8. B tier. Next, AppyPy. Customization option, 1. Extend with custom code, 0. Templates, 2. Code export, 0. Success stories, 2. Web and mobile, 2. Documentation, 2. Total score of 9. B tier. Next, Choicely. Customization options, 2. Extend with custom code, 0. Templates, 1. Code export, 0. Success stories, 1. Web and mobile, 0. Documentation, 1. Total score, 5. And again, 0 for documentation is disappointing because it's extremely important regardless of platform. B tier. Next, Jotform apps. Customization options, 1. Extend with custom code, 0. Templates, 2. Code export, 0. Success stories, 1. Web and mobile, 1. Documentation, 1. Total score, 6. B tier. Next, AppMaster. Customization options, 2. Extend with custom code, 0. Templates, 0. Code export, 2. Success stories, 1. Web and mobile, 2. Documentation, 2. For a third time in a row, total score of 9. B tier. Next, DraftBit. Customization options, 2. Extend with custom code, 2. Templates, 2. Code export, 2. Success stories, 1. Web and mobile, 2. Documentation, 2. Total score, 13. A solid contender for A tier and just behind Flutterflow. And now our last entry, Starion. Customization options, 1. Extend with custom code, 0. Templates, 0. Code export, 0. Success story, 0. Web and mobile, 1. Documentation, 1. Our last entry scores a total of 4. I admit I might have missed some stuff while checking them out, but hey, as a product owner, it's my job to make it easy for potential users to understand what I offer. So sorry, Starion, to the crap tier. Now, let's look at the results and I'll share my takeaways from this. Guys, this video wasn't the easiest to make, but my heart told me it was something that folks on YouTube would find useful. I haven't showered in 2 weeks. My girlfriend is making me sleep on the sofa. If you did find it useful, please leave a like, subscribe, and I'll know it was all worth it. Results. Out of 15 no-code mobile app builders, we have 1 in God tier, 4 in A tier, 9 in B tier, and 1 in crap tier. Are you surprised? I'm not. If you're looking for a mobile app builder in 2024, these are my 4 takeaways for you. Number 1, you don't always need a God tier app builder. Originally, we decided on a God tier app builder as a bit of a joke to show that even the best platforms aren't perfect. I still don't think Flutterflow is perfect, but for the purpose of this video, it's a God tier app builder. Well, it's God tier by my estimate anyways, but I don't want you to think it means Flutterflow is the best choice for every no-code mobile app project in the world. All I would conclude from this is that it's extremely robust and doesn't lock users in. And if I was going to build a no-code mobile app that I wanted to really put effort into, I would seriously consider Flutterflow. Nothing more than that. You know even gods aren't perfect, right? 2. You have a pretty safe selection of options. Look, there's one crap tier app builder out of these 15. And I admit, it could just be me being a crap tier detective. But the other 14 exist on a spectrum of decent to amazing. And I think the biggest implication for non-tech founders is that your app builder is not going to be so bad you can't do anything with it. You're assured with a decent minimum level of quality. So I say pick a tier, pick an app builder whose strengths are what you need and go for it. Number 3, code export seems uncommon with mobile app builders. You know, I don't remember code export being so rare among no-code app builders. Out of 15 app builders on this list, only 3 offer code export: Flutterflow, DraftBit, and AppMaster. It's probably a lot harder with mobile, or they saw Bubble locking users in and thought, good idea. So if you value code export, you're limited to these 3. Number four, my tier list is a place to start, not end. With the basic framework, I could filter options from a pool of 15 app builders. I think it's a great way to quickly evaluate the strengths and weaknesses of a builder. But my tier list is still a bit too general. Two app builders can have the same overall score, but look at the breakdown and they excel at different things. Or they don't excel at anything, they're just decent across the board. So personalize this framework with metrics that matter to you. In my previous video, commenters were suggesting things like community and pricing, and I can totally see the argument for that. Then you consider an app builder not based on how good it is, but how good it is at what you need. More on that personalized framework, check out this video where I suggest no-code app builders to commenters and I walk you through my thought process. I go in depth about how you can come up with your own framework to evaluate no-code app builders. Meanwhile, I'm thinking of making this tier list an annual thing. Every January, we kick off the year with a giant tier list of all the no-code app builders. If you like the sound of that, comment an app builder you'd like to see ranked. Leave a like and subscribe if you haven't, and let's see how to find the right app builder for your project by yourself.